Color red is Demacian crew. Just remember that big peepee swag is Demacian crew, and you'll never go wrong. That's that's the part that's the way I remember it.
All right, big peepee swag
is Demacian crew. Yeah, Demacian crew is the one with all the messed up names. That's the other way you can remember it.
Demacian crew is red, and bot lane is blue, folks. This is the first ARAM of our tournament that we've broadcast on the live stream. In other words, the first ARAM of the day, and I'm excited. Honestly, I wasn't expecting this at all, but we'll wait to see how it plays out. The view here, are you getting like a really eagle eye view? Is that just the way ARAM looks? It's just very top down looking?
Yeah, it's just the map. It's Hell Abyss.
Two Jack in the Boxes, they got to be careful they do not pursue this team fight in enemy bush. That is bot lane. They do not want to get feared. The Folly just took out the Jack in the Boxes there, so they're good.
Yes, it
now
did.
They've inhabited enemy bush. Bot lane now in the position of power, as we expected.
With look at Volibear's items, Angus.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Rejuvenation pendants.
Health regen. I don't care about anything but health regen. My name is Volibear. So he'll be building a horn for sure. Take advantage to add up to that crazy regen.
Yeah, I've actually had the pleasure of playing ARAMs on Volibear more than once. And I gotta say, he's really strong. Whoa, Fiddlesticks almost giving up first blood to Yorick zombies. Also narrowly escaping the tip of that volley.
Abs gotta be careful.
The first blood is still 400 Gs in ARAM, am I right?
Right.
Okay, so yeah, first blood is somewhat significant.
It is.
In ARAM.
Man, Yorick too, great poke on this map. I just realized, bot lane's team is so strong right now. If I were the Demacian crew, I would be biting my nails at this point in the match, man. Yeah. Just already. It's scary. But it is more of an early game advantage that bot lane has. You know, the poke only goes so far. It really does come down to team fighting in the end game. And at that point, I don't feel like their advantage is as severe as it is right now.
Right. Yeah, I think that that's definitely going to be more of a late game. Just like you said, it's the advantage right now is not that big of a deal. The poke is annoying, but it's not. It's a pale shadow of what it's going to be in 15 minutes when Severe and Ash are just running wild on their team with just crazy, crazy damage. And there's really nothing that Demacian crew can do to respond to that. So they're kind of getting pooped on by this ARAM. It's too bad.
Yeah. Unless we see like AP Ash or something. But given how she's already bought two Doran's Blades, I really doubt that's going to happen.
Yeah, not the most likely thing in the world.
Keisha's saying that the stream is going to be going for 3 to 4 more hours. Wow, that's a long time. Yeah, this is pretty typical of ARAMs. If you guys aren't used to watching ARAMs from a spectator standpoint, there's going to be a whole lot of tower humping in the early game, especially against a poke comp like the one that bot lane has here. And it's just, I wouldn't say it's uneventful, but it's definitely very one-dimensional. There's no ganking going on here. It's very heads up.
Yes. Absolutely. There's no worry about, you can dive a tower without having to worry about Lee Sin coming out of the jungle or whatever. You know, you don't have to. And there's not a. The thing is, you can make a lot of crazy plays because honestly, you don't give up that much when you die. I mean, it's like, well, you died. Well, yeah, well, you get a chance to buy, so you kind of get something for free. You know, you actually get something out of it. In addition to that, there's a lot of passive gold and passive experience. So giving up gold and experience to the enemy team really isn't that big of a deal because you continue to gain both while you're dead.
Yeah.
So yeah, it encourages high risk play, which is always great for a stream.
Yeah, we'll take a look at the CS so far. It looks like Ashe definitely ahead, grabbing up all those last hits with her volley, and of course Severe.
Sure.
Tailing. Actually, she just took lead with her boomerang. I know, it's so exciting. We're counting each last hit here, folks. But yes, obviously the AD carries have a huge advantage here in terms of last
hits. Top flight play-by-play is what we're talking about right now.
Oh man!
Wow, look at Chrysalis, that little rat getting shredded. And two chains. Oh, so close.
Yeah, he tried to go for that flash grab on Volibear.
Yeah.
Just straight out of the bush. That's got to be terrifying.
Yeah, just a bear come charging out of the brush. Why didn't I see you? The grass isn't that tall.
Kha'Zix also has a decent amount of poke, I just realized. With that tier of the goddess, though, he's not going to be dealing any real damage until he starts to get some AD. But, yeah. Kha'Zix also a very strong... He's definitely the strongest player, probably, on Demacian crew's ARAM, I would say. Chrysalis is about to go down, though. If he takes one more volley, I don't think he has any more potions. No, he has no more health potions. He's definitely going to die. He'll probably give up first blood. I would like to see a snipe to the face with an ash arrow on Chrysalisk.
Yeah, definitely. What you're saying about Kha'Zix being one of the stronger champions, he's definitely the best champion that they got stuck with here on Demacian crew. Any reset champion has a huge advantage here because of the nature of the lack of sustain. Like, you can't go back and heal and whatnot. So people are forced to stick around with very low health, and that's wonderful for anybody who thrives on resets, because it means that there's somebody that they can target, they can initiate, use all their abilities, and get the kill, and then get a reset, and then use their abilities again, and get another reset, and so on. So it's okay. Perfect setup. I mean, it's
Ash
the ideal.
Just hit
it's
level
the
six.
Ideal setup.
Ash just hit level 6. Will we see the arrow used? That would have to be a tower dive. I think she's going to hold off. They might be able to take this tower first.
Yeah, it almost looked like they wanted to force the tower. Here comes Abs with a Crow Storm. And unfortunately, though, they're only hitting the Revenant. not that helpful. And with Crow Storm down, there's a real opportunity here. Crystal Arrow is still available. And everybody's bunched up in the wrong place to be. However, Fiddlesticks does manage to get the first blood. That's impressive. And the little rat Teemo going down immediately after. Look at PP Swag's health.
Slammed by zombies.
Arrow was used, but here comes 2 Chainz with a dive. He is going to get him. Will he survive his own dive? One more tower hit, and he died for it. But Kha'Zix died too, so it's all good. And there goes the tower. So a 2-for-2 exchange and a tower kill. So obviously bot lane very happy about how that turned out, and that's only going to get worse as the game continues.
Yeah, the first deaths are the most important in an ARAM because it reveals what sort of builds these players are going to go for. Obviously, they wait to finalize their builds. They're not going off cookie cutters here because they have to wait and see how the enemies are building as well. But the first buy, especially when a first blood is that late, you know, 17,000 gold already been dispersed, is very telling.
Yeah.
So it does look like nothing out of the ordinary here at all. Holy Bear is really the only one with a peculiar build with his life regen. Kind of crazy.
Well, I'm sure he'll get his battle horn soon, but he's already got the Hextech Sweeper. I alluded to this at the beginning of the match, that although they do have 2 characters with invisible traps, they can just buy Hextech Sweeper, and it detects it when he gets near it. He doesn't even have to use the mist. It's a passive. And that's quite a bit more powerful than the old Dominion version that launched back when Dominion first came out. So he loves it. I mean, there you go. He can just take that mushroom out like it's nothing.
Mm-hmm. So Ash is going back here. What the heck is Garden Salad doing there? I think he went all the way back across the map just to get some some of the health regen there.
Maybe. Probably worth it. I mean, they want to engage right now. I mean, look at everybody's health. Certainly they want to engage. They can kill Simplex. Simplex cannot dive with that kind of health. I mean, that's what Olaf is made to do, and he can't do it. he'll have his attack speed with his passive, but by the time he closes the gap on foot, he'll be dead.
Look at Lif using the spell shield to break that shroom just ahead of time as he gets that health buff, just so that his team doesn't have to deal with that damage. Really high level play. I mean, it's kind of funny saying high level ARAM play, but
everything is
like
on
that.
The line. No, I mean, it really is for this team. Boomerang Blade's ready. There's the crystal arrow taking out Abs before he can use Crow Storm. That was such a huge get for them right now. With Abs down to 15 seconds, they have a real shot at taking this tower, or perhaps diving and picking up a kill on 2 or 3 people. And, Lif is definitely in a position to murder them. However, Abs is coming back alive now. There's a dive from 2 Chainz. Let's see if he's going to get something done with this before Abs comes back. With Abs comes back with a Crow Storm, he can wipe their whole team. They're taking too long now. Everyone's so low.
They just need to focus
barely
on
escaping.
This tower.
Here comes Abs. Is he going to come in, get something done? I don't know. He looks a little scared.
Bot lane really should have taken that tower there instead of chasing all those kills. It's just not worth it. I mean,
yeah,
his kills aren't as
they
could
have taken the tower with that time. Then they could have gone after the kills, and they probably would have got him too. Under the tower, Ash is going to focus down the tower. There it goes. And Beast just barely surviving with a barrier. PP Swag in there getting resets, getting 2, but he finally dies. He started the fight way too low. And 2 Chainz going to stay alive and slap it out with here. Abs now at nearly full health, and there's a triple kill for 2 Chainz. They're going to fight down Poor. They're going to destroy Poor. Fiddlesticks, the Scarecrow getting ripped apart by the bear and the ninja.
Yeah,
you know that bears are the natural enemy of Scarecrows?
What?
I just made that up.
You crazy.
Yeah.
Yes, Inhibitor does go down for the Demacian crew. Well, most likely, I would give up my life. Okay, never mind.
Yeah,
Kha'Zix.
I think If Big PP Swag had been at full health at the start of that fight, then they definitely would have won it, because he jumped right in, immediately got a kill and a reset. And he could have chained right after that. But his health was so low in the beginning that all it took was one quick little burst from two chains and he was done.
Yeah.
Oh well.
The question in the stream, why haven't these guys picked 1v2 or 2v2? I think you got it right. There's a whole lot of pressure in front of a live audience. It's all eyes on you. This is a team game. League players aren't used to being singled out. So I think that's probably has a lot to do with it.
You might be right.
Yeah, bot lane definitely taking advantage of their team comp advantage. Did I use advantage in that last sentence?
Yeah, a couple times, yeah. You might notice that Fiddlesticks is having trouble keeping his health up. He got bursted down pretty quick. If you've ever played Fiddlesticks in ARAM, it is so hard to use your life drain, because your whole team will just kill the minion before you can get any health back. It's ridiculous.
Oh,
so
Revenant,
yeah. Revenant going down to force that inhibitor is actually a really smart idea.
Yeah, and, it looked like he got the last hit, but no, Volibear jacked it from him.
And everybody's low on the Demacian crew. They can't fight right now.
It's a time bomb here, folks. All we need is one good Ash Arrow. She's ready to headshot somebody right now.
Yeah, and Chrysalis looked like it'd be in a good spot there. I wasn't sure if she was waiting for that or what was going on, but at any moment, Teemo could get slammed in the face by a Crystal Arrow, and we will all rejoice.
I will. I hate Teemo, man. Just kidding. I love Teemo.
Yeah.
My latest Facebook picture has me in a Teemo hat. You guys doubting my commitment to Teemo. But where is this Ash Arrow? We need to see a freezing arrow right now.
Yeah,
I guess
let's do it.
Yeah, he's playing it easy. He's waiting for them to make a misstep here.
Or he's waiting for the super minions to catch up. That's the most likely thing. And there it is. There's the big mech with two maces. Gonna push down this tower. And now it may be time to dive.
I think that Ash Arrow was a bit late. Come on, let's see it.
We're all sitting here on the edge of our seat waiting for this player to throw his ult. Oh, there it is on Abs, and he gets bursted down. The volley and the boomerang blade finishing the job.
Yes.
Oh my god.
The
next wave coming up. Next super minion that's up, they're going to want to push this tower down. I mean, they can force it. They can just fight them and let the super minion do the work.
Yeah. The lifesteal now from the AD carries on bot lane is just too strong at this point. They're able to sustain in lane with the amount of damage they're dealing. It was over before it began.
Oh,
with this
Abs
team
is back up.
Selection.
Abs is back up. He has Crowstorm. Could see a repeat of the last time when he came in with full health and was a pretty big decider. But he did eventually die there. Let's see if he can get something done now that he's at full.
Oh,
Chrysalis is getting picked too. They're going to get a return pick, getting Lif. And now Beast is in the fight, getting kind of low, but he is through York, so he doesn't mind. Here comes Crowstorm. A little bit late, but that's okay. And they're going to pick up one quick kill. Ash still running around here, out of
Voli's
position. Revenant keeping him alive.
Voli's looking to make this happen right now.
Oh, Volibear. Oh, man. Two chains just destroying any chance they had.
No,
and Peepee Swag going for the wrong target and taking him out. But he did make him burn the Revenant at least. I mean, that's something. And now they're going to force down a tower perhaps, unless they, too ballsy.
Man.
Guardian's Talent. Oh, I don't know if you just saw what just happened, but God, I thought that was really slick. So Guardian's Talent was sitting there in the middle of Revenant mode, right?
Yeah.
So he shot Teemo one time just to get tower aggro, because he knew that the tower hits didn't really matter to him. That way that two chains could just punch the tower without being attacked. So he just attacked Teemo one time, then went back. That's perfect.
Yeah.
That's such a great split second decision too.
Yeah, it's really good use of that Yoricle, which is so underutilized. I mean, it's so much different than a Zillion ult or something like that, because at that point their life is forfeit. You can do whatever you want, Red Moon. You just kamikaze and try to make the best of it for your team. It's very unique.
Yeah.
Look at Teemo's HP rat.
I know, he's such a little troll. Somebody kill that stupid rat, come on. there is a stream set up by Riot called Teemo Dies, which is just literally just streams Teemo dying live.
Really?
Random instances of Teemo dying as recorded by the spectator
mode. Why haven't you linked
this
to me before?
It's a pretty fun gimmick, but it's not something you watch all day. What they really should do is they should add ones where he comes very close to dying and make it like maybe one third of him when it comes close but survives. That way you're on the edge of your seat each time. That would be really fun. But since you know he's going to die every time, it's not as fun. It gets old. Anyway, a little more fighting over this tower. They're going to force down this tower right now. Chrysalis can't even do anything. As soon as he comes into the fight for one attack, he's gone. Before he even gets an attack range, he's gone.
Yeah, this is one of those Mount Thermopylae scenarios right now. Demacian crew, they're trying to hang on. They want to keep their spot in the tournament, yeah. But this last tower is all they have standing between them and defeat.
Yeah, regretting that ARAM for sure. Because Huge Rectum's arguably their best player is being wasted. Or PB Swag, hard to say. One of their best players. Anyway, there's a Crystal Arrow to shut down PB Swag.
Botlane selected the ARAM.
Yeah.
Demacian Cruz didn't want to have anything to do with this.
You're probably right. Yeah, I think I am mistaken. But they could have banned it. But that's okay. It actually turned out to be, regardless of who picked it, it definitely worked out for Botlane. And they're going to get a 15-minute victory. Isn't that exactly what I had said? 15 minutes, and that's when the AD carries are going to crush them?
Komar's ideas always prevail, guys.
Always. Except I can't keep track of which team is which. That's about it. All right. That was fun. So that's it. Bot lane winning 4 Division 3.
GG. That means that the bot lane is going to progress, and they'll be matched up against 2.0 Gaming, which should be tomorrow.
Yeah. Well, goodbye, PP Swag and Huge Rectums. We love you, and we'll miss you. And looking forward to seeing you in the next tournament.